Joshua and Reagan, welcome. Are you ready?
So let's do it.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today for one of the happiest occasions in all human life, to celebrate before God the marriage of a man and woman who love each other. It is our joy to witness and celebrate the wedding as Joshua and Reagan become one.
While I'm off chasing my own dreams, sailing around the world, please know that I'm yours to keep, my beautiful girl. When you cry, a piece of my heart dies, knowing that I may have been the cause. If you were to leave, fulfill someone else's dreams, I think I might totally be lost. You don't ask for no diamond rings, no delicate strings of pearls. That's why I wrote this song to sing, my beautiful girl.
Okay, I think I'm done.
So we pray that this couple may fulfill God's purpose for the whole of their lives by always living within this love and within this joy. With our love, we support Joshua and Reagan as they freely give themselves to each other.
When you run into my arms, we steal a perfect moment. Let the monsters see you smile. Let them see you smile.
As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy might be in you and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I love you.
Will you run back into my arms like you did when you were young? Will you come back to me? I will
direction. Life is beautiful, but it's complicated. We barely make it. We don't need to understand.
Joshua and Reagan, I don't need to tell you that today marks a complete new beginning in the lives of both of you. Your wedding lasts only today, but your marriage is for the rest of your lives. Today, you both go back to the school again, the school of marriage. Today, you begin to learn again, to learn to love each other in a deeper way. You are joining yourselves to each other today to become one, without, of course, losing your individuality. Becoming one means getting free of all selfishness out of your lives, because there is no room for selfishness in marriage. Marriage, my dear brother and my dear sister, is a school of love. I, Joshua,
take you, Reagan,
to be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to be true.
Promise to be true.
To you in good times.
To you in good times.
And in bad.
And in bad.
In sickness.
In sickness.
And in health.
And in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Okay? And Reagan, repeat after me. I, Reagan,
take you, Joshua,
to be my husband.
I promise to be true
to you in good times
and in bad,
in sickness
and in health.
I will love you
and
honor you all the days of my life.
If I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe, say you will.
Reagan,
take this ring
as a sign of my love,
as a sign of my love,
and fidelity.
And fidelity. Together,
in the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit,
and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
You wear white and I wear out the words I love you, and you're beautiful. Now that the wait is over, love has finally showed her my way.
Joshua, take this ring. That's funny. The ring?
Take this ring.
As a sign of my love.
As a sign of my love.
And fidelity.
And fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
Father.
And of the Son.
And of
the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Good.
Promise me you'll always be.
Look with love upon this woman, your daughter, now joined to her husband in marriage. She asks your blessing. Give her the grace of love and peace. May she always follow the example of the holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May he always honor her and love her as Christ loves his bride, the church. Father, keep them always true to your commandments. Keep them faithful in marriage and let them be living examples of Christian life. Give them the strength which comes from the gospel so that they may be witnesses of Christ to others. Bless them with children and help them to be good parents. May they live to see their children's children, and after a happy old age, grant them fullness of life with the saints in the kingdom of heaven. Amen. An honor to me to introduce for the first time in public Mr. and Mrs. Zottnick.